We have to put pedal to the metal and build the new energy. Some of these new technologies that we've been talking about, like, for example, green hydrogen, the cost curves have changed massively. And I think this point on affordability is really important. You can't just put all the dollars in building new green infrastructure now. You actually have to put real dollars in decarbonizing the existing grid. And for example, work on methane leakage reduction. You have to do that now as a transition path to net zero.
I like to think about it in terms of three main levers that are going to get us there. It's investment, it's technology, and it's policy. Policy enables new industries to come about. Once you have policy in place, investment follows. Alongside of that is getting technologies to actually be able to work at scale and at an appropriate rate of return for an investor. And we're going to see that in relation to carbon removal technology.
I think private sector companies and some state-owned enterprises are saying, you know what? We have a point of view, we're going to create carbon markets, we're going to drive nature-based solutions, and that will be a way for us to actually monetize our nature capital and use it for the transition.
Everyone sees the obstacles, but if you can see the bright spots, that capital's available for the transition, the certain policy environments are going to enable that technology development and acceleration.
I think the world we live in today is a lot more difficult than what I think we had anticipated a year ago. We have to unleash innovation and build the energy infrastructure of tomorrow.